Greetings, Mzansi, and welcome to Afternoon Express. I'm Palisa Tembe, and we have got a fun Fashion Express Thursday edition for you today. We're being joined by the accomplished Kat Ntala, who worked her way to national prominence as a presenter on Yo TV. She has also gotten multiple pageant title holder and has recently launched her very own modeling agency. We'll also be hearing from Old Mutual's Head of Financial Education, Ujohn Manyike, as he breaks down how the incredible AMP Studio initiative is benefiting aspiring and up-and-coming musicians. From sticker book collections to signed rugby balls, we all had something that we could show off as a kid. So tell us on social media, what was your biggest flex growing up? Use that hashtag AfternoonExpress in all of your comments. Former Miss Teen SA Kat Ntala went from being an everyday tomboy to a teenage beauty queen, and now at 20 years old has just started her own premium modeling agency and academy. Now she joins us now via Zoom to chat all about it. Kat, welcome back to The Loft.
Thank you so much. Hi everyone. Thank you once again for having me on the show.
You know, it's so lovely to see you. Seeing you grow up in front of our eyes on television, I mean, I feel like you're already so much a part of the SABC family. Sengithi, welcome back. But welcome to Afternoon Express. It's such a pleasure to have you.
Definitely. Thank you so much. You know, sometimes I can't believe it. And I'm always just like, Kat, you're turning 21 next year. It's been 4 years since you've been a TV presenter. Like, goodness me, time really does fly.
Absolutely. Now, let's start at the beginning of how you became a teenage beauty queen. How did you transition from being a tomboy to a girl with no experience in the beauty space all the way to Miss Teen SA?
You know, just like you said, that I was a tomboy, and every single sport at school I played, you know, like hockey, swimming, athletics, soccer was my absolute favorite. And I think that adventurous trait was just in me because I saw a video on YouTube. I think it was the Miss Teen SA pageant. And I just thought, okay, this looks absolutely awesome. So it was something that we've never done before in the family, but I decided that I want to enter a pageant. Obviously, with every other pageant, the first one is never as smooth, but it's always memorable. And literally from there, the rest is history. I mean, I think it was 2 years until I actually got my first title, which was the Miss Teen Africa title. And that eventually did open up doors for me to go onto the international stage.
Now, Kat, how has your career and platform grown after becoming a TV presenter on SABC One's Yo TV?
You know, absolutely incredible, you know, because I was a sports person at school and not so much of, you know, the dramatic arts or speaking, but everyone said that I had that bubbly personality. Now, the thing is, my sister at school was the star. Like, in every single play, she was the main character. So automatically, the drama teachers thought, you're up next, you know. And I remember there was a day I was in grade five. Everyone was like, Kat, you made it to the Buzzy Malone casting. And I'm like, but I didn't even audition. Like, what are you saying? So that has always been in me. And I think with pageants, a lot of judges, a lot of people would always come up to me and say, you know what, you belong on TV. I went for a presenting course. And from there, there was a post on Facebook on the Yo TV page. And they were like, we're having open auditions. And I thought, heck, like, why not? Let me just go try it, you know? Yeah.
Now we have to discuss your academy, the KN International Modeling Academy, which has just opened up in the beautiful cities of Johannesburg and Cape Town. Now, why was this so important for you to start this academy, and what do you hope to achieve with it?
Man, it's so important, I guess, because, you know, I've been there. And the whole story of my academy is based on the fact of, like I always say in every interview, everyone I tell, that my first pageant was an absolute disaster. But I was fortunate enough to actually have someone to come up to me and say, I'm going to train you. But how many girls in South Africa go to a pageant without that formal training? And immediately, before they even get onto the stage, they are disadvantaged because they don't have the training, they don't have the grooming. And then they are discouraged after that because no one comes up to them to say, actually, I can train you. This is how it's done. Or in other cases, you know, they don't have the resources to actually access that type of training. So KN was literally made for that. That girl, let another girl never go into a pageant like Kat with her frizzy perm like she did, the pink shoes that she wore instead of silver shoes. And, you know, I mean, it was just, but the thing is, it really, it was a learning block for me. And I guess if that experience did not happen, KN would not have been born.
Yeah.
You know, so that's really what I hope to achieve at the Academy, is that to really train and build, but most importantly, just instill that confidence in girls that you can too, and there is space for you, be it in the pageantry world, modeling, or even just the entertainment world at large.
And Kat, you know, furthermore, one important aspect of the Academy that I think we have to put focus on is the Academy open to everybody from various backgrounds and sizes.
Yes, definitely. So I don't know if we had, if you had seen our official photographs, but we literally brought everyone in, you know, your plus size girls, your tall girls, your short girls. And the thing is, because I'm also short, people think I'm tall, and I guess that's because of social media, maybe I look tall, but I'm actually the tiniest person you'll ever see. And, you know, a lot of people are already put off because they have this whole perception that you need to be a certain way, you need to be a certain size to get into the industry. But what are we telling a 10-year-old girl who does not look like every other 10-year-old that she can't do pageants because of the way she looks? What are we instilling in her at that young age, you know? So it's very important that we create a space that is really inclusive. And I'm very proud to actually say that pageants have been evolving over the years. It's been opening up where we see a lot of, you know, inclusivity of different kinds of people, different backgrounds. And that's what the Academy is also trying to push, is that, yes, you're 10 years old. Yes, you are cute and you will enter a pageant. You just need the confidence. It's not about how you look or where you come from.
Well, that is so beautifully said. I can just see how passionate you are, Kat, about everything that you're doing within the modeling space, La Mzansi. So I definitely do salute you. I congratulate you on not only the incredible career you've had as a TV presenter, but also making a mark with the young girls coming up after you. Thank you so much, sis.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. I'll be back soon, I hope. I don't know for when, but y'all see me.
Oh, we trust you. Don't worry, girl. We'll be twinning throughout. Now, if you could achieve all of this at the tender age of just 20, imagine what we'll be discussing with Ukat by the time she's 30. We salute her work to empower and uplift all young women, and we can only cheer on as she continues to pursue her goals.